Iceman!
The mountain bike trails at Lake Rebecca Park Reserve are a super fun ride through a remnant of the big woods that once dominated southern Minnesota. You can find the mountain bike trails at Lake Rebecca Park Reserve at 9831 Rebecca Park Trail in between Rockford and Delano, Minnesota. The trailhead area features plenty of paved parking along with a portable toilet and a couple of vault toilets. On the path leading up to an expansive picnic area are water fountains and a bottle filler. The single track trails at Lake Rebecca are part of the Three Rivers Park District system of parks, and they're maintained by the amazing volunteers of MORC, the Minnesota Off-Road Cyclists. MORC is a huge asset to the mountain bike community, and they deserve all of the praise that we can send their way. Check out their website and consider a membership, or better yet, show up for a trail work session. Membership and trail work info can be found at morcmtb.org. All right, now let's get on the trail. There's just under 13.5 total miles of single track if you ride all of the stacked loops. Riders of all abilities can handle the entire track. Just come prepared for the miles and the punchy little hills in the intermediate and advanced trails. Now, I had never ridden Lake Rebecca, so Abby showed me around one afternoon.
I really like to ride for distance, so Lake Rebecca's 13-ish miles is a good length for a solid ride. There is also the opportunity to ride shorter loops. So if you don't want to ride the full 13 miles, you can opt for a shorter ride. The trails aren't too difficult, so they are a great place for me as a beginner to focus on improving my basic bike handling skills as well as increasing my speed.
The start of the trail is at the north end of the parking lot. Head through the sign and you start the easy trail. The easy trail winds through the prairie area with pockets of wide trails through the woods. This is a great way to get warmed up and ready for when the intermediate trail starts. There's super handy signs at all of the intersections helping to guide you through the system. At this intersection, the sign told us that we could continue forward on the main trail where the intermediate trail starts, or we could hang a right to stay on the beginner trail. This is what I mean by stacked loops. The beginner loop, the intermediate loop, and the advanced loop are all stacked on top of each other. So you can ride them individually, or you can ride them as one big loop. Abby had to adjust her tire pressure a little bit, and then it was into the intermediate trails. The intermediate trail gets a little bit narrower, and you start to see more bumps, humps, and berms. You're also going to start to see some feature lines like this one that let you play around on some jumps and some rocks. But if you're not interested in those lines, there's always ride arounds. Things start to get pretty flowy at this point, and it's fun to just glide through these twists and turns. As you're making your way through the trails, keep an eye out for these brown signs on the side of the trail. These are mileage markers, and it's 1/4 mile between each marker. After a little bit, Abby and I came across this little fun group of logs to play on. Pretty soon, we came upon a parent and a kid enjoying a nice evening in the woods. I'd been hearing them talking and laughing for a while. Lake Rebecca is perfect for that. Back into the woods and more flowy fun. We didn't have time to stop, but there's a nice rest stop where you can take a break if you need to. These side hill sections are pretty fun as you roll along above the lake. Around this bend, you come across a fun little log pile and then a few rock and log features to play on. This one took me a couple of tries, but eventually, I did it. Forgive the sweat smear on the camera. It was humid this day. This little rock line was super fun to float down. Another trail crossing where you can hang a right to head back to the trailhead or continue forward to keep going on the intermediate trail. Right. We hadn't had enough, so after we consulted the map, of course we went forward. At this point, we came to the start of the advanced trail where we could have hung a right to skip it and continue on the intermediate stuff. But nope, we were all in for this ride.
Like I said earlier, I consider myself a beginner rider, maybe beginner to intermediate. But there's nothing on the advanced trail that I can't either ride or take the ride around. Soon I'll be riding more features than Rob.
The advanced trail brings with it some faster turns, some punchy climbs, and some fun, quick downhill rips. After more ups and downs, we made it to the intersection with the intermediate trail. A right turn lets you repeat the loop, but we were getting hungry, so we went left to finish up the intermediate stuff. With the camera finally cleaned up, old Peter Cottontail here wanted to race, but he knew that I was way too fast, so it was back in the brambles for him. Not much to talk about here, just some more sweet dirt ribbons sweeping through the woods. We popped around a corner and came to another paved trail crossing, and yet another opportunity to extend the ride. We went forward though, on our way to finish the intermediate trail and back to the car. Just after that crossing, we came across this super fun double log pile. We finished out the intermediate trail and then the beginner trail, and we made it back to the trailhead.
Lake Rebecca is a good trail system to build general fitness on a mountain bike. It would be fun to ride the loop a couple times through to get a good number of single track miles in on one ride. Lake Rebecca is the trail that I head to when I want to just put my head down and ride hard, figuratively of course. If I put my head down too much, I'm bound to hit a tree.
I'm really thankful that Abby showed me around Lake Rebecca. While there aren't as many rocks, logs, skinnies, jumps, or berms that you may find at other trails, Lake Rebecca is a relatively new trail, and I'm sure the trail crew has some super fun stuff in mind. What it lacks in trail features, it more than makes up in flow and beauty. It's super fun to roll through the woods and then pop out into a prairie and then climb up a hill and then do it all over again. I hope to get back here really soon. Be sure to check out our blog at shopericks.com for more trail reviews. And if you or your bike need anything, stop by your favorite Eric's location before hitting the trails.
He pedals good bikes.